Hello and welcome to the news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Bulfatih. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, the Supreme Commander, today paid a visit to the General Command of the Bahrain Defense Force, BDF. Upon arrival, His Majesty was welcomed by the BDF Commander-in-Chief, Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa. His Majesty was accompanied by the Royal Court Minister, Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed Al Khalifa. His Majesty was welcomed by the Chief of Staff, Lieutenant General Diab bin Sagri Naimi, and a number of senior BDF officers. He was informed about the plans of the BDF's various branches and units, expressing pride in the BDF and its brave personnel who have set the best example of loyalty to the nation, courage and discipline. His Majesty expressed thanks to all the BDF affiliates for protecting the kingdom's achievements attained thanks to the citizens' dedication and their solidarity. He wished the BDF personnel further as well as everlasting progress and prosperity to the kingdom. The Shura Council Chairman Ali Al-Saleh presided over the Council's weekly meeting, which discussed amending Article 59 of the Real Estate Law 13-2013. The Council approved the balance for the end of the financial year of 2019 and the performance report of the National Audit Office for the same year. The Council also approved the request of the Financial and Economic Committee to withdraw a suggestion to add a new article to Decree No. 78 of 2006 and to review it further. The Chairman of the Supreme Council of Health, Lieutenant General Dr. Sheikh Mohammed bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, delivered a speech at the celebration organized by the Ministry of Health, the Bahrain Diabetes Society, BABCO, and the Southern Governorate on the occasion of World Diabetes Day. He affirmed that the Kingdom attaches great importance to diabetes, which is one of the public health challenges and has a profound impact on the health on individuals and societies. He indicated that some cases of diabetes can be largely prevented through physical activity and a health-balanced diet. At the ceremony attended by the Minister of Health, Faiq Al-Saleh, the prevalence of diabetes has doubled worldwide, and most of these cases are of the second type. The Minister of Interior General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa chaired the 38th Joint GCC meeting, which was held in the Kingdom. The Minister welcomed the attendees, including the head of the current session, after which he gave a speech on behalf of the Kingdom.
يطيب لي في مستهل كلمتي أن أتوجه بالشكر الجزيل إلى أخي العزيز الفريد سمو الشيخ سيف بن زايد آل نهيان نائب رئيس مجلس الوزراء وزير الداخلية بدولة الإمارات العربية المتحدة الشقيقة رئيس الدورة السابقة على ما قام به من جهود موفقة ساهمت في تعزيز التعاون الأمني بين دول المجلس. كما يسرني توجيه الشكر إلى معالي الأخ الدكتور نايف بن فلاح الحجرف الأمين العام لمجلس التعاون لدول الخليج العربية وإلى الأمانة العامة على حسن الإعداد والمتابعة. معرباً عن اعتزازي برئاسة هذا الاجتماع والذي يأتي في إطار العمل على تنفيذ توجيهات وتطلعات أصحاب الجلالة والسمو قادة دول المجلس من أجل بلوغ الأهداف الأمنية المرجوة. ومن حسن الطالع أن يتم انعقاد هذا الاجتماع حضورياً في مملكة البحرين، وذلك ثمرة للجهود الكبيرة التي بذلتها الدول من أجل التعافي من جائحة كورونا وحماية الصحة والسلام العام. أصحاب السمو والمعالي الحضور الكريم، في ظل ما تنعم به دول المجلس ولله الحمد من أمن واستقرار ونمو وتطور بفضل حكمة قادتها وإخلاص شعوبها، وهو الأمر الذي يعد مصدر فخر واعتزاز، يأتي اجتماعنا اليوم وما سبقه من اجتماعات تحضيرية من قبل اللجان الأمنية المختصة، وهو ما يهيئ فرصة عملية للوقوف على آخر المستجدات والتحديات والتطورات الأمنية مثل الاعتداءات الإرهابية باستخدام الصواريخ والطائرات المسيرة والهجمات السيبرانية، بالإضافة إلى الإعلام الموجه والتطرف العنيف. وفي هذا الإطار أؤكد على أهمية مراجعة وتعزيز إجراءات الحماية المدنية من خلال تبادل الخبرات والاطلاع على التجارب العملية في هذا الشأن من أجل تحقيق أعلى معدلات الحماية والسلام العام. ولا يفوتني هنا بأن أؤكد على إدانة الهجمات الإرهابية المتكررة التي تتعرض لها الشقيقة المملكة العربية السعودية، مؤكداً على موقف مملكة البحرين المؤيد لكل ما تتخذه المملكة من إجراءات وتدابير أمنية للحفاظ على أمنها واستقرارها وسلامة مواطنيها وأراضيها. كما أنتهز هذه الفرصة للإشادة بجهاز الشرطة الخليجية الذي يتم حالياً العمل على تطويره ووضعه في الإطار الذي يحقق أهدافه في ظل دعم دولة الإمارات العربية المتحدة الشقيقة للجهاز للنهوض بالمهام المنوطة به. واسمحوا لي أيضاً بهذه المناسبة أن أهنئ دولة الإمارات الشقيقة باستضافة وتنظيم معرض إكسبو دبي 2020، والذي يقام للمرة الأولى في الشرق الأوسط، وما يعكس هذا المعرض الدولي من شراكة حضارية إنسانية من أجل مستقبل أفضل للبشرية. أصحاب السمو والمعالي الحضور الكريم، تعتبر منظومة تبادل الخبرات أساساً في تعزيز التعاون الأمني المشترك، وهنا أضع أمام مجلسكم الموقر تجربة مملكة البحرين وما أنجزته بفضل الرؤى الملكية السامية من لدن سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة عاهل البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه، وتوجيهات ومتابعة صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد رئيس مجلس الوزراء الموقر حفظه الله ورعاه لبرنامج العقوبات البديلة وبرنامج مراكز الإصلاح والسجون المفتوحة كمشروع وطني وحضاري وإنساني يستهدف تطوير منظومة العدالة الجنائية ومواصلة تعزيز حقوق الإنسان، وهو ما يأتي تأصيلاً لما حافظت عليه مملكة البحرين في تعاملها الإنساني، مستمدين ذلك من ديننا الحنيف وعادتنا الحميدة. ختاماً، أتمنى لاجتماعنا التوفيق والسداد والمضي قدماً في تعزيز الجهود المشتركة لتطوير آفاق التعاون الأمني بين دول مجلس التعاون في مختلف المجالات وتعزيز الاستقرار والرفاهية والسكينة في أوطاننا. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
The meeting discussed various topics relating to security from the agenda, which are geared towards further cooperation and improvement of performance in facing the challenges in the region and the world. The Secretary General of the GCC expressed thanks to the attendees and to the Kingdom for its hospitality and efforts in furthering GCC cooperation. He also thanked His Majesty the King and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister for their ongoing support for GCC cooperation with the aim of preserving safety and security. He affirmed that GCC solidarity with Saudi Arabia in its efforts to safeguard its stability, security and safety. On the sidelines of the GCC meeting, the Minister of Interior General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa signed an MOU with his UAE counterpart, His Highness Sheikh Saif bin Zayed Al Nahyan, on cooperation in the cyberspace. The MOU will facilitate the exchange of expertise and data when tackling cybercrime and cooperation in innovation and technology. The Interior Minister praised the deep-rooted bilateral ties and affirmed keenness on further deepening them in all fields. He expressed appreciation for the UAE's positions towards the kingdom and said that the MOU will enhance the fraternal relations, especially in the field of technology. For his part, His Highness Sheikh Saeed affirmed the deep-rooted bilateral ties and wished the kingdom further success and prosperity. The Minister of Foreign Affairs, Dr. Abdul Latif bin Rashid Al-Zayani, met with his Saudi counterpart, His Royal Highness Prince Faisal bin Farhan Al Saud, on the sidelines of Sir Banias. They highlighted the strong bilateral relations and ways to further enhance the cooperation between the two countries in order to achieve the aspirations of the two countries and their people. The meeting also included discussions of political and security developments on the regional and international levels, in addition to topics of mutual interests. The Minister of Industry, Commerce and Tourism, Zayed Al-Zayani, visited Bahrain's pavilion participating in Expo 2020 Dubai. The minister toured the pavilion and was briefed about the exhibits that represented the cultural heritage of the kingdom with its well-known antiquity and diversity. Al-Zayani praised the kingdom's pavilion and hailed the distinguished architectural design of the building and the dedicated efforts made by the Bahrain Authority for Culture and Antiquities to enrich the kingdom's participation in Expo 2020 Dubai. The Shura Council Committee for Foreign Affairs, Defence and National Security affirmed its support to the statement of the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Dr. Abdul Latif bin Rashid Al-Zayani, regarding the inalienable historical and legal rights of the kingdom based on the principle of not violating the inherited borders regarding the territorial sea of the Kingdom of Bahrain and the adjacent areas. It affirmed that Bahrain, under the leadership of His Majesty the King, believes in the importance of committing to all international rules and decisions, and also affirmed that Bahrain reserves its sovereign right to demand a just and equitable claim for the restoration of all its historical rights. Following the article in Le Point newspaper, the committee calls on Qatar to respond to the successive calls made by the kingdom to start bilateral talks, according to the statement of Al Ula agreement, with the aim of addressing all outstanding issues. The United Against Nuclear Iran organization hosted Bahrain's ambassador to the U.S., Sheikh Abdullah bin Rashid Al Khalifa, as a speaker in its annual events in the presence of senior political figures and members of the U.S. Senate from both parties. The ambassador highlighted the security threats and challenges at the regional and international levels and stressed Bahrain's endeavors to preserving the navigational movements in the Arabian Gulf through many alliances with countries. He called on the concerned countries to intensify efforts against potential dangers and indicated that Bahrain's foreign policy, whose foundations were laid by His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, places the interests of the citizen at the top of its priorities. The American Chamber of Commerce in Bahrain, AmCham, and the Bahrain Indian Society, BIS, are set to hold a forum tomorrow looking at the opportunities the Bahrain-US Free Trade Agreement, the FTA, for Indian companies and highlighting the benefits provided by the FTA since its signing 15 years ago. To speak more about the event, we are joined by the AmCham Bahrain Vice President, Mr. Ali Musa. Hello, Mr. Ali. It's good to have you here with us tonight. Can you tell us more about the event and how can it help further open doors for Bahraini, American and Indian businesses to flourish?
Good evening. AmCham is very pleased to partner with Bahrain Indian Society and Bahrain Economic Development Board and the U.S. Embassy as part of the American Chamber ongoing efforts to support the business growth and developments in the kingdom and promote the use of the U.S.-Bahrain Free Trade Agreement. This year, as you may know, we recognize the 15th anniversary of the U.S.-Bahrain FTA, and its many benefits that have led to bilateral trade more than triple since the FTA went into force in 2006. There was over $2.5 billion of bilateral trade in goods and $1.5 billion in bilateral trade of services between Bahrain and the U.S. in 2019. The pandemic impacted the global trade in 2020, but we are seeing a return to strong trade again. This event in particular that we are hosting and partnering with the Bahrain Indian Society and Economic Development Board is part of our initiative to promote the use of the Bahrain-U.S. Trade Agreement, and we hope to highlight the benefits that Bahrain can bring to the Indian companies to leverage the FTA.
Mm-hmm. That is amazing. Thank you very much. We wish you and the forum the very best of luck. That was the AmCham Bahrain Vice President, Mr. Ali Moussa.